in calculus. Today we are going to discuss chapter 5, that is continuity and differentiability. Okay. So before moving on to the continuity part, we have some important formula of limits. This you might have studied earlier. So we have some important formulas, and that will be used somewhere when we will be discussing the continuity part or differentiability part. Okay, so let us remind, just for a quick revision. We can see that limit x tending 0, sin x equals to 0, limit cos x. So those who are important and quite frequently used in solving the problems that I am taking out. So limit x tending 0, sin x equals to 0, limit cos x tending 0 equals to 1, and this is also very important, that limit x tending 0 sin x upon x equals to 1, or in inverse form also we can write that limit x tending 0 x upon sin x, that is also 1. Similarly, limit x tending 0 tan x upon x equals to 1, and the inverse is also possible. Limit e to the power x tending 0 is 1, and so on, the other formula. So whenever it will be required, I will remind you, and you can have this class notes to refer it later. So now, continuity and differentiability. Okay, so continuity and differentiability we are going to start. So what is continuity? Let us say you have a function. This is x and y axis, and let us say you have a function like this. Like this you have one function fx. Okay, so what is the meaning of continuity? First of all, you must know what is the meaning of continuity. So continuous means, as the word the meaning of the word suggests, continuity means continuous. Without lifting up the pen, if you can draw the graph of the function, and that function is called continuous. Okay, means there should not be any point of discontinuity on the xy plane. If the function is continuous, let's sin x function, it is continuous. You might have seen the graph of sin x. Okay, so it is continuous at all points. Here is domain. So y equals to sin x means discontinuity exists if you have to lift up your pen for drawing the graph. Let's say at any point it is discontinuous, like, so I will discuss it just now. So suppose f is a real function on a subset of the real numbers, and let c be a point in the domain of f, then f is continuous at c if this relation holds good. If this relation holds good, that is, limit fx x tending to c, c means the point at which we are willing to check its continuity. Okay, let us suppose if we are willing to check the continuity at x equals to a, so obviously it will be what? Limit fx and x tending to a. Okay, and this should be equal to f of a. Means if we are putting the value of x as a, then the function should be equal to the limit x tending a. And this, when this is satisfied, when this relation is satisfied, then only we can say that the function fx is continuous at point a or around point a. Okay, so in this chapter you will be given various functions, and you will be given the points, and you have to check the continuity of the function at the given point, whether it is continuous or not. And to understand what is continuity, I have told you that if you are drawing the graph of the function and you don't have to lift the plane. Means there is no break in the graph. There is no point of discontinuity in the graph. Then we can say that the function is continuous. But you have to check the continuity at one point. Whether and what is the meaning of limit? If I say ki limit x tends to a and fx. So what is its meaning? Let's say this is the graph fx and the point here is x equals to a. So the point is x equal to a. So this around x equals to a, to the left of it and to the right of it. Okay, limit means to the nearest close, the very close to the left hand side and very close points to the right hand side, if it is continuous on both sides or not, if it is defined on both sides or not. Okay, and it should be equal. So limit of extending a fx means we have the left hand limit, that is extending to a minus of fx, and we should have the right hand limit, that is RHL, and that we write, here it is limit so LHL means left hand limit, and how we write it, this limit extending a minus, okay, and then it is fx. This is your left hand limit, means we are concerned with the points which are lying left to a, hai na? And what is right hand limit? Right hand limit is limit extending a plus and fx, and by calculating or by determining RHL, right hand limit, we are concerned with the those points which are lying right to x equal to a. Okay, so what are the points which are lying right? These are the points. Okay, and the point lying left is this one. Okay, so we are checking the LHL here and we are checking the RHL in this portion. And if the function is continuous, then both has to be equal. The LHL and RHL both must be equal for the point, for the function fx to be continuous at point A. Okay, and not only this should be equal, but it should all be also be equal to f of A. Then we say that by this definition your function fx is continuous at x equals to a. Okay, now I will explain it with more clarity for by taking some more examples. Okay, so let's say you have a function fx, equals to 1 and 2, and 1 is defined if x is less than or equal to 0, and 2 is defined for the condition that if x is greater than 0. Okay, see, it has a different meaning. X is less than or equal to 0 and x is greater than or equal to 0, both have different meanings. Okay, x is less than or equal to 0 means we are concerned with those points of x which are lying left of 0 on the xy axis. Okay, and x greater than 0 means we are concerned with those points of x which are close to x but lying right of 0. Okay, and equal to 0 means the value of fx is 1 by this, by the given function which is shown in your on your screen, fx equals to 1 if x is less than or equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? It means that the value of fx will be 1 for all the points lying at x equal to 0 and left of it. Okay, so we will try to understand it through a graph. So let us draw a graph, and then this point will be more clear, I think. So this is a graph, and let's say this one is your x-axis. X-axis, and this is your y-axis. And this one is negative x, that is x dash, and this one is negative y, that is y dash. Okay. Now see the function. Fx equals to 1 for x less than or equal to 0. So this one is the origin. We all know very well. This is the origin. So on which portion of this graph this x less than 0 will exist? On which portion of this graph? In the negative half. Means left of 0. So of which portion I am talking? This is the portion of the graph which is x less than 0. Okay? In this portion x is less than 0. And in which portion it is greater than 0? This portion it is greater than 0. Okay? So this is the portion where we have x is greater than 0. And x equal to 0 is this point. This origin point or y axis. Any point on the y-axis is x equals to 0. Is it okay? Any point on the y-axis is x equals to 0. So now we have to plot this graph. Fx equals to 1 if x less than 0, we have to plot this. So how can we plot? If we have to plot, so how we can plot? Now for all the points of x less than 0 means in all these portions we have fx equal to 1. So we can simply draw a line parallel to x axis, and the value on y axis should be 1, like this. So this line is showing x equals to 1. If I write here 1, if I write here 1, then this line, this blue color line drawn left of the negative half x axis parallel to the negative x axis, the value of it is 1, and according to the question fx equals to 1 if x is less than or equal to 0. And one more thing, x, when x is equal to 0, then also the fx value of fx is 1. So it is defined for x equal to 0 also. So in this way we can take this point also. Okay, this point also. Because for x equal to 0 and x less than 0, everywhere the value of fx is 1. Okay, now move on to the next condition. If x is greater than 0, then the value of function fx is 2. So for fx greater than 0, and now this positive half x axis, this is the portion of x greater than 0. So in this portion, the value of fx is 2. So how we can draw? We can draw it like this. Okay? And now this is, let's say, on the y axis, it is 2. Now according to the given condition, fx equal to 2 for all x greater than 0. But one thing is there, that for x greater than 0 it is 2, but for x equal to 0 it is not 2. So this for x equal to 0, this is not defined. Okay, it is defined only for x greater than 0. For x equal to 0, this 2 will not exist. Okay, so in this way, through this graph, we can have the inference ki whether this function is continuous or not. whatever I have discussed so far, according to this, if the function is called continuous only when the function is continuous around any point. And what is the point we are discussing? That is 0, x equal to 0. So around 0, is it continuous? Tell me. Is it continuous? I say no. Why it is not continuous? Because what I told you, that the function is told to be continuous only when we can draw it without lifting the pen. And can you draw this graph without lifting a pen? Means there is some point of discontinuity at x equal to 0. And if there is some point of discontinuity, certainly this function is not going to be continuous. Okay. So, every time it is not quite possible and not required even to draw the graph and then you shall discuss the continuity. So, there is some condition which I had discussed just now. This condition is given. And through this condition, we can check whether the function is continuous at any point C. Let's say for this, any point A. So, whatever point is given, you have to check whether the function is continuous or not. So, this, for your illustration only, I have drawn this graph and tried to make you understand whether it is continuous or not. But from the next time, you have to check what? What you have to check? You have to check the left hand limit. Then, the left hand limit, that is limit fx extending left hand limit, so a minus, this should be equal to your right hand limit, and that is limit fx and extending to a plus, and then this should be also equal to the value of function at x equal to a or whatever point you are discussing. Okay, so this is the condition which you have to check, and if this is satisfied, then only we can say that the function is continuous, or if any of this condition is not satisfied, then the function is discontinuous. Otherwise, the function is discontinuous. Okay, so I don't think that it is so much tough. It's quite easy. Is it tough? No. Okay, so through this graph it is clear ki why I am saying in this case that it is discontinuous, because you move from the left, let's say like I am drawing the graph, but can I go to this point without lifting my pen? Can I go to this point? No. So we will have to lift up the pen, and as soon as you lift the pen to draw the graph, this means that at this point, the graph is what? This function is discontinuous. Okay? So, this function is discontinuous. But what I told you, it was just to make you understand. Okay? From the next time, you have to check these conditions. And if these conditions are satisfied, the function is said to be continuous. Okay? So, now we will move on to solving the questions. So the question is, check the continuity of the function f given by fx equals to 2x plus 3 at x equals to 1. So the function is fx equal to 2x plus 3, and the point at which you have to discuss the continuity, that point is given x equals to 1. Okay? So you know that what is the condition? The condition is this, limit should be equal to fx. And if it is just simple, then limit fx x tending a equal to fa. Okay, so now we will check. So we have this fx, equals to 2x plus 3. This fx equals to 2x plus 3. Now, how we have to check? I have told you earlier that for the function f to be continuous at point A, what is the formula? Limit for any point x equal to A. In this case, it is x equal to 1. For in general case, for any point x equal to A and the function to be continuous, limit of x tending A fx should be equal to the fa. Okay. So, we will proceed to solve this question and we will discuss whether the given function fx equal to 2x plus 3 is continuous or not at x equal to 1. So, in this case, for we have to check this relation. So, first of all, we will calculate the limit. So, limit fx. So, limit fx and x tending, the point is x equal to 1. So, x tending 1. And it will be equal to limit x tending 1. And since you might have some knowledge of limit, so you know that till the point we substitute the value of x in the function, we will have to write this limit. Okay. So, 2x plus 3. And now you can directly put the value of x equal to 1, because if the function is complex or by putting the value of x, if you are getting the indeterminate forms. So we have to avoid the indeterminate forms in calculation of limits. But if by putting of x you are getting some real values, then it is okay. So indeterminate forms are what you have to avoid: some kind of 0 by 0, infinity into infinity. These are some things which you have to avoid. Okay. So here there is no condition of 0 by 0, infinity or infinity by infinity. So we can directly put the value of limit, and now the function is 2 into 1 plus 3, and so limit fx x tending 1 equals to, this is 5. Okay, so we have calculated this part we have calculated. Now we have to calculate this part, the remaining part, fa. So what is fa? If I write f of a, so f of a is what? Since instead of a you have been given x equal to 1, so you have to write f of 1, or you have to calculate f of 1. And if you will calculate, then f of 1 means you have to put the value of x as 1 in the function given above. So, it's 2 into 1 plus 3, and that is 5. Now, you can clearly see that limit of fx x tending a is also 5 and fa is also 5. So, if both are equal, then what we can say? Then we can say that the function is continuous. Means we have checked the continuity, and since both are equal, so we can say that the function is continuous at x equals to 1. So we can write here, okay, hence the function f, the given function f is continuous, continuous at x equals to 1. So is it I think it would be clear to all of you. So in this way it's a very simple question, so that you can understand ki how we can calculate the continuity. Okay, similarly for the other functions or other questions also we will solve it. Okay, so let's say taking the another question, so that the function f given by fx equal to x cube plus 3 if x not equal to 0 and 1 if x equal to 0. So what is the meaning of x not equal to 0? X not equal to 0 means x not equal to 0 means x less than 0 and x greater than 0. Only the x equal to 0 is not included. Okay, but x not equal to 0 means x less than 0 and x greater than 0, both are covered in this, excluding x equal to 0. X not equal to 0 means it is not defined for 0. Okay, otherwise it is covering less than 0 also or right than 0. So in the axis what I had discussed in the earlier question, x and y axis, so the points to the left of 0 and points to the right of 0, for both of them we can say that x is not equal to 0 and the value of function is x cube plus 3, and for the point x equal to 0 this is the value of function is 1, and we have to show by checking the continuity, we have to show the function is not continuous as x equal to 0. So in this case, around which point you have to discuss the continuity? The point is x equals to 0. Okay, so we will proceed in the same manner, and I would like to again remind you ki on what condition we have to check the continuity. We have to check the continuity on this condition ki limit x tending a fx equals to f of a, and if this relation holds good, like in the previous question this relation was satisfied, this condition was satisfied, and so we came to the conclusion that the function f is continuous at x equal to 1. So in this case we have to prove that it is not continuous. So certainly this relation will not be satisfied, and if this condition is not satisfied then we can say that it is not continuous. So we have to calculate first of all this limit, x tending a, and then limit x tending a, and then fx. So what is a in this case? What is the point? This a is x equals to 0, so we will write like this: limit x tending 0. Now x tending 0 means what? X less than 0 and x greater than 0. Okay, and for both the points x not equal to 0 we have x cube plus 3. So for x tending 0 the function, the value of function will be x cube plus 3. So here we will write it's x cube plus 3. Okay, now what I had told you ki check that whether we are, by putting the value of x, are we getting this in that form 0 by 0 infinity or infinity into infinity? If we are not getting such indeterminate forms, then we can proceed just by putting the value of x. So calculation of limit is very easier here. By putting x equal to 0, it's 0 cube and plus 3. So finally this limit x tending 0 and fx equals to, this fx equals to 3. Okay, so this is 3. Now we have to calculate this f of a. This f of a we have to calculate. So f of a, or we can say the point a is here, x equal to 0. So better we write f 0 equals 2. Now when x equal to 0, what is the value of fx? 1. So f of 0 is 1. Now you can see that limit fx x tending 0 is 3 and f a is 1. Certainly both are not equal, and thence what we can say, the function is not continuous. So this way we can conclude that since limit fx x tending a is not equal to fx f tending, or better instead of writing a, you write the point. Okay, instead of writing this a, better we write the point. Okay, so what is the point? Extending 0 equal to f of 0. And since this relation is not satisfied, condition has not been satisfied, so the function, the given function f is not continuous, at x equals to 0. So in this way we have shown it or prove it. Okay, moving on to the next question. We have this question. Okay, and simply we can again discuss the continuity. Okay, but in this case, see, we have to proceed in another manner, quite dissimilar to what we have done so far. Because x less than 1, there is another condition, and for x greater than 1, there is another condition. Okay, so in this case, instead of calculating the limit for x tending 1, we'll have to calculate LHL, RHL, and then for x equal to 1. Okay, so how we'll proceed? What I have told just now, let me write the condition. If you have the different points, x less than 1, we have x plus 2. For x greater than 1, we have x minus 2. And for x equal to 1 also, obviously, it is x plus 2. So, in such cases, if you have, in the last case, what is what given? X not equal to 0. For x less than 0 and x greater than 0, for both the condition, the value of function was x cube plus 3. But in this condition, we have different value of functions for x less than 1 and x greater than 1. So in this case, the condition is similar, but we will have to expand like this. We will have to check the left hand limit, that is left x tending a minus, this is left hand limit. Then we will check for the right hand limit, that is limit x tending a plus of fx, and this both should be equal to further f of a. Now this condition we have to satisfy for this question whenever there is a different value for greater than 1 and minus 1, greater than 1 and less than 1, or x greater than a or less than a, like this. Okay, so let's proceed to solve this question. Now, for x less than 1, for x less than 1 means we are talking of left hand limit, means LHL, this LHL, left hand limit will be limit x tending. Now, since we are writing left hand limit, so don't write x tending 1 simply. Just write x tending 1 and minus. This minus is representing you are calculating the left hand limit. Minus means left of 1. Okay. And then there is fx. Okay, so here it is limit x tending 1 minus, and then fx. For x less than 1, we have the value of function as x plus 2. So we will write x plus 2. Okay. So we will write x plus 2, and it is simply let's say instead of 1 we should check for plus 2, we can simply put the limit, so it is 3. Now similarly we can calculate this RHL also. Now RHL is for x is greater than 1. Now RHL will be how much? Limit x tending 1 plus and then fx. And this will be limit x tending 1 plus, and now for x greater than 1 we have the different value of function, that is x minus 2, so we have to keep it x minus 2. So now it will be 1 minus 2 equals to minus. So certainly we can say that LHL is not equal to RHL, okay, and since the both are not equal, and obviously if I calculate the third condition, that is FA or it is F of 1. So for F of 1 also, they go x equal to 1. So for this condition also, we have x plus 2 and we will certainly get the value of 1 plus 2 equal to 3 only. Okay. So these two are equal. This LHL and this FA are equal. But again RHL is giving some different value and this is not equal. Okay. This is not equal. So we can write this relation, what we have written just here, is not satisfied. And since this relation is not satisfied, so what we can say, that f is not continuous, f it, since we can write this, since in this case LHL is not equal to RHL, and since LHL is not equal to RHL, so there is no point of satisfying this FA. So function, the given function f, the given function f is not continuous, at x equals to 1. So x equal to 1, at x equal to 1 the function is not continuous. Okay. So in this way we can check the continuity. Fine. Now we will move to the next question. See this question. The function fx is defined as fx equals to x square minus 9 upon x minus 3 if x is not equal to 3. Now again, not equal to 3 means what? For x less than 3 and for x greater than 3, for both these points, what we can say, that we will have the same value of fx, that is x square minus 9 upon x minus 3, and for x equal to 3 the value of function is, for x equals to 3 the value of function is 6. Okay, so we'll have to solve this. How we have to solve? Let's see. Now again, what I told you, it is better if you proceed by calculating the left hand limit, right hand limit, and then f at 3. Okay. So tell me one thing, that if I want to calculate the limit of this given function, let's say if I want to calculate the limit of this function at x tending 3, the function is, let's say, x square minus 9 upon x minus 3. So you might be having some little idea of the limit. Tell me that so far we have been putting the value of x in the function and we are calculating the limit. So can we proceed like this? Can we proceed similarly for this question? If we do like that, if we put the value of x in the given function, then this will be 3 square minus 9 upon 3 minus 3. So it is what? 0 upon 0. And this is certainly not desirable. This is the indebted form. This one is the indebted form. I told you some minutes before that we have three, normally we have three indebted forms, 0 upon 0, infinity, and infinity into infinity. So such forms must be avoided, or anyhow we have to substitute anything and avoid this indebted form. Otherwise the limit is not defined. Okay. So this way we cannot proceed for this question. Now in what way we have to proceed then? So let's see. We have to proceed like let's say we have to calculate LHL. I am discussing how we have to proceed for this type of questions. Let LHL is there, so limit, and you are checking for x tending, let's say x tending a, and LHL it will be a minus and fx. So in this case you have to put x equals to a minus h. Then this limit will be what? If you are putting x equal to a minus h, so x tending a will be, now it will change to x tending 0. Okay, and this fx will be f of, in place of x you have put a minus h, so it will be f of a minus h. And then you have to calculate the limit further. So in this way we have to proceed. So let's see in this way if we proceed, so how we can solve this question. Okay, so here it is. Now we have to satisfy this condition. This condition you have to satisfy, this one, the limit, you have to satisfy this condition, limit fx extending a minus equal to limit fx extending a plus equals to fa, or simply we can say that left hand limit equal to right hand limit equal to the function at a. Okay, so we have to proceed that way in this question also. So now for LHL, let us suppose we are going to determine the LHL, left hand limit. So left hand limit will be limit x tends to, and around which point you have to discuss the continuity so that the function is continuous. So discuss the continuity at x equal to 3. So here we will write 3 minus. Okay, and then we have this function fx. Okay, now we are talking about 3 minus left hand limit, means we want to consider those points of x which are lying left to x. So for x not equal to 3 we have x square minus 9 upon x minus 3. But before, so we will write limit x tending 3 minus f of x is x square minus 9 upon x minus 3. Now we have simply shown, I have tried to simply show you that if we put the value of 3 directly into the function, then we are getting this indent form. So anyhow, we will have to avoid this indent form. So now we have discussed for LHL, you can solve like this. You put x equal to a minus h. So if I put x equals to a minus h, so what is a here? A is the given point, that is x equal to 3. So x equal to 3 minus h. And if I put like this, then our limit will be, now your limit is going to shift from x to h. So previously it was limit x tending 3 minus, now it is going to be h tending 0, and your whole function will be transformed into h. Okay, this will be the function of, previously it was function of x, and now it will be the function of h. So by putting this, now suppose put x equal to 3 minus h in the function, then we will have this 3 minus h whole square minus 9 upon 3 minus h and minus 3. Okay, so this way we can proceed. I have to solve, simply solve this. Now a minus b l square, this is 9 plus h square minus 6 h and minus 9 and upon minus h. This is going to cancel out, this 3 and 3, in here also the 9 is cancelled. So we have this h square minus 6 h upon h, and this h we can take common, and this limit also we have to carry. This limit also we have to carry here. Okay, so we'll have to write the limit, because we have not yet put the value of limit, so we will have to write the limit. So equals to limit h tending 0. Okay, now the next step will be, limit h tending 0, and here it is, h we can take common, so h minus 6 upon minus of h, and this will be this h and h will be simply cancelled out. So we can write this, h simply, limit h tending 0, and this minus we can take above, so this is 6 minus h, instead of h minus 6, now this will be 6 minus h. Now see, it has been transformed into the simplest form now. So now we can directly put the value of h, and certainly we are not getting any kind of indeterminate forms. So just directly put the value of h, so 6 minus 0, this is 6. So we can say that our LHL is 6. Okay, LHL is 6. Now consider for RHL. Now we will go for RHL. So for RHL, now you have to proceed simply as you have done in this. Okay, so for RHL, we will move like this. For RHL, I am talking of the general rule which you have to follow in all the questions, and then we will do for this question. But for general rule, like the, we have calculated this LHL in order to avoid this indent forms. So now this will be limit x tending. Now we are calculating RHL, so it will be a plus. Previously it was a minus. And then fx. Now you have to substitute for LHL we had substituted x equal to a minus h, for RHL we will substitute x equal to a plus h. Yes, a plus h, and then after substituting x equal to a plus h, the whole limit will be transformed into, previously it was x tending, previously it was x tending, now it will be h tending 0, and this function will be, now it was previously x, so after putting the value of x as a plus h, the function will be f of a plus h. Okay, so we will proceed in the similar manner for this question also. So we will proceed in the similar manner. So limit, what you have to write, RHL, and limit x tending, and the x is 3. We have to decide the continuity at x equal to 3. So in place of a, we have been given 3 here. So it is 3 plus, and here it is f of x. Okay, this is the question. So actually we have this limit x of 3 plus and fx. What is the fx? For x greater than 3 also, we have x square minus 9 upon x minus 3. So it is x square minus 9 upon x minus 3. Now, I have just told you how to proceed for RHL. We have to substitute. For RHL, we have to substitute x equal to a plus h. Okay? So we will have to substitute. Let put x equal to a plus h, and a is 3. So 3 plus h, which we have to substitute. Now after substituting this, the limit will be transformed from x to h, and this is limit h tending 0, and here the function will be x plus 3 whole square minus 9 upon x plus, it's x equal to 3 plus h actually. So we have to put in place of x 3 plus h square minus 9 upon 3 plus h minus 3. So we'll solve it further. So it will be 9 plus h square minus 6h minus 9 upon its h, because this 3 will be cancelled and this 9 will also get cancelled. Okay. It is plus 6h. So now we will take h common, and again I have missed the limit. So please don't do this mistake. Again I have missed this limit. So we'll have to write, because till the point you are not putting the value of h in the limit, you have to carry on with this. So now the limit h tending 0, and this is what h, you can take common, and this is h plus 6 upon h. Why I did not put the value of h here? Because again, if you put the value of h, you will get the indent form 0 upon 0, that you have to avoid. So here now we can put the value of limit. So it is 0 plus 6 equals to 6. So again, your RHL has also come out to be equal to 6. So this LHL was also 6, okay, and this RHL has also come 6, and the third condition which you have to check for is x equal to 3. Okay, so for the third condition which you have to check is x equal to 3. So for x equal to 3, the value of function is directly given, that is 6. Okay. So there is no point of any confusion. F of 3 equals to 6. It's already given in the question. and so this all three are equal. Now you can see that this all three, this LHL, this RHL and this f of a, all are equal. So we can write that yes, certainly this function, the given function f, is continuous at x equal to 3. So how we can write? Okay, since this f of x extending, limit extending 3 minus f x equals to the LHL, certainly limit extending 3 plus, and it is going to be the RHL, and equals to f of 3. Since all these three are equal, so the given function f is continuous, at x equals to 3. So in this way we can check the continuity. We will solve some more questions related to this in another class. So stay connected.